are Velocities in Music, VIMTV, here today to review Handsome Fur's third album, Sound Capitale. I gotta say, I think this is the best album artwork I've ever seen. That's just it. I just wanna keep listening to this album because of the album artwork, and that's all I'm going to say about it. Handsome Furs, you guys should know of who is Handsome Furs right now, because it's Dan Bechner of everyone's favorite band, Wolf Parade. And, you know, Wolf Parade got big and famous in 2005 when they released Apologies to the Queen Mary, and then in 2007, Dan Bechner and his wife, Alexei started their own, you know, indie electronica duo group, husband and wife combo. Nothing like Mates of State or anything, but certainly something that's very expansive, progressive, but very electronic in sound. Especially this new album. This Sound Capitale, their third release. The third release in 4 years, which you gotta kind of commend.
Yeah. Especially when he's had other projects.
Oh, absolutely. And numerous other outcrops of music here and there. The guy's just on fire. I feel like anything that comes out of that area of Canada is just
it's gonna be good.
Very luscious.
Yeah.
Bechner, you know, provides this edge to this to his music that I've always liked, so I was really excited to review this album. Now, this album was written, the Handsome Furs wanted to focus on writing melodies that are electronic. They wanted to use synthesizers to write melodies and hooks, and that's what the whole basis of this album is. So you get, I think a lot of Handsome Fur fans will come back to this album and go, you know, this is a little bit different than their previous work, and really I'm interested to see whether or not you guys like the transition or not. To me, I really did like it because I felt like it had a lot of the edge that I was speaking of that I love about Bechner, and you know, you get all these different electronic melodies being thrown at you, and some of them are supporting the beat, and some of them are just providing kind of an undertone to the song, and then some of them are just these really catchy melodies. Mm-hmm. And then you have, every once in a while, Bechner will put his signature, you know, just really, really super distorted guitar low in the mix in the background to fill out the sound and everything. I love that. And his vocals, to me, carry it. But that's just kind of what the sound is. Tom, what were your thoughts? What'd you think about Sound Capitale?
Well, carrying right off from what you were saying about that rock edge, that is what I really notice. And just to carry your comment a step further, is that that's what really, to me, sets this apart from a lot of that new kind of, electronica, but like a dancey sound.
Yeah, disco revival.
Yeah, that's been really popular lately. The thing that sets this apart for me is that edge. Mm-hmm. Dan Bechner isn't trying to be pretty and make these, you know, poppy, catchy hooks. Mm-hmm. He can make catchy hooks, but he can give them lyrics that actually have some depth. Mm-hmm. The first time I listened to this album was, it was streaming ahead of schedule, you know, before its release on Spin's website. Mm-hmm. And on that page, there was an interview, and while I was listening to it, I was like, why not? Why don't I read this interview? And it was really interesting because a lot of this music was inspired by the duo touring Asia. In different parts of Asia that, you know, had different, you know, political systems and things that they just weren't used to.
They're making a reality kind of documentary show on it, right?
Really?
Yeah.
That sounds awesome.
It's for TV and everything, so I'm really excited
to see that too now. But, you know, it shows through in this album in the lyrics, and that gives it a theme. Mm-hmm. It's not just dance tune after dance tune, which to me just gets old. They really mix it up with that. And because of that, you can tell in Dan's vocal performance that he really cares about what he's singing about. Mm-hmm. And I like that.
Mm-hmm. Gives it warmth. It gives you a reason to care about the music rather than just put it on at a party and just drink some light beer to it, you know?
Yeah.
That's not what this is about. This is something more.
Absolutely. One thing, the only big complaint that I really have... Well, I mean, you know, it's only 9 tracks, and while the last track is quite a bit longer, it's a little short, you know, not too grand of a scope. Also, I just feel like, you know, from that, they could have taken it a step further, I feel like. With these big ideas and concepts that they want to show in their music, and you know, this political edge to it, the rock edge to it. I feel like they could have just let loose and go nuts. I still feel like they're even restricting themselves a little bit. It's a step in the right direction for sure, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's nine really solid tracks, but they could do more with it.
Yeah.
Know, they could expand the idea. And really, I want to, in our last episode, you know, that we did throwback to the Arcade Fire's funeral, or Arcade Fire's funeral, depending on which side of the disc you're looking. And what I talked about with Win Butler is his ability to vocally just emote and just how he controlled the sound through his voice. And Beckner is very much the same way. And probably that you picked some of that up from Wynn, since he toured with Wolf Parade for the Arcade Fire, and when they were debuting that album on that tour, they opened for him. So he probably picked up some you know, little things about his style. But Beckner has this really growly kind of slurred voice. He almost sounds drunk at times. But he actually, I think it adds a lot to the sound.
Oh,
he really has
a
ton of control over it, and you can just hear this emotion just dripping off of it, and it makes it much more engaging, especially when you combine it with the lyrical content you were talking about. And to me, that's one thing that really sells this album, and pretty much anything that works. Now, to me, my biggest gripe about this album is production. Tom talked about how this is kind of different from all the other current artists in this genre that's getting a lot of attention right now. And one thing, I know Tom and I, you know, Holy Ghost, Cut Copy, we didn't like those albums quite as much as a lot of other music reviewers and even you guys out there, and that's okay. One thing that we did note about those albums, though, that we really liked and respected, that you guys all noted too, was just how awesome and thick and full that production is. And on this album, that's just not there. I feel like the production, this album's more produced like something that Wolf Parade would do, but where Wolf Parade is covered in, like, it's supposed to sound messy and visceral and all these sounds being thrown at you.
Like, all the parts are there.
Yeah.
Like you were talking about with the synth undertones and then the leads, they're all there, they're just not quite mixed and produced to their fullness.
It's not as crisp, it's not as full sounding as it could be, and I really feel like they could do things, whether it's an EQ or just in the general little idiosyncrasies of the production, which you know all about, that they could have done things more to beef it up. That would put the sound quality on the same level as all those other bands, but then you would have all those other really good qualities about this sound, like great vocals and really great lyrics and songwriting and song structuring and all this cool stuff that other bands aren't doing right now, and that would really set them apart and make this top of the class. All in all, I really liked it. I'm sitting around a 79, right at the cusp of very good. It's just really solid. Really something that I think everyone should check out.
I'm going to give it a 78.
What a booger.
I'm a weenie.
Hey, we're averaging out to a 79, so it's all good.
Yeah.
What did you guys think? Did you like Sound Capital? How about that album cover? Do you find that offensive, profane? Do you want something a little bit more, you know, do you think it fits the music, I guess? I'm interested to see what you guys think. Please leave us a comment at www.velocitiesinmusic.com or youtube.com/velocitiesinmusic. Follow us on Twitter. Like us on Facebook. That's where we talk about music. I'm Jake.
I'm Tom.
And we are VIMTV, Moving Music Critique Forward. Well, here comes the future.